Welcome back. Austerity measures have struck this year's Zifi celebrations. DFF says this year government has kept control even on party celebrations during this film festival. Zifi organizers have also decided to give red carpet welcome to Goan filmmaker Lakshmikant Shedgaonkar on Sunday, which he missed last time because of mismanagement. Director of DFF S.M. Khan addressed Meet-Fest press conference on Saturday. He said the turnout for film festival was very encouraging and delegate numbers have shot up to 6,500. This year, ESG has slashed its budget for IFFI by almost half than last year. Directorate of Film Festival, however, kept its budget same to ₹2.50 crores. But DFF says government is keeping eye on spending at IFFI and they have adopted the austerity measure.
Because of the austerity measures and all that, there were certain limitations about the invited guests. So the Ministry of Finance, Government of India, they, after everything was taken into, only 600 guests were to be invited.
Austerity measures were much talked amongst political and government circle after Union Finance Minister Pranab Mukherjee introduced it for his own ministers. Would this austerity really make big change in IFFI? But the good news for Goa is that Lakshmikant Shedgaonkar will get red carpet welcome once again on Sunday. On Monday, Lakshmikant Shedgaonkar had to miss red carpet because of mismanagement.
And as far as the red carpet is concerned, he will be given a red carpet tomorrow. He has agreed, yes.
A senior reporter from Panji, Rakesh Kandolkar, with video journalist Anil Sanadi. Ramdas Hazare, councillor who entered Congress with a blank form, has admitted that submission of unfilled form was a mistake. Hazare was one of the four councillors who were seen submitting a blank form during their formal induction into the Congress party.
Ramdas Hazare has admitted that there was a mix-up while submitting the forms. He stated that over 400 forms were submitted on that day. So no one noticed the blank form that mistakenly made its way to the top of those forms. Hazare also said that he has formally resigned from the MGP and has spoken to GPCC president.
I am a 4.5 form. आता बाय मिस्टेक दिसता ते फॉर्म वयर उरले कॉन्जिबिशन रिजाइन झाला एमजीपी हायन पयर भाषणा सुद्धा सांगला एमजीपी दोन फाट गेल्लो हांव सोमारा आनी मंगळारा ऑलरेडी रिजिग्नेशन लेटर हायन भितर घालून येयला आनी एक ऑफिशियल रजिस्टर केल्ले हा फाल्यां आनी कांय प्रॉब्लेम नाका म्हणून कित्याक
एमजीपी प्रेसिडेंट पांडुरंग रावत ऑल्सो मेन्शन दॅट हजारेज एक्झिट वील नॉट हार्म एमजीपी इन एनी वे एज ही वॉज नॉट एट ऑल वर्किंग फॉर द पार्टी. Hazare had contested on MGP ticket from Fatoda constituency in the last assembly election.
Renunciation delay kwa na delay etun maka isan odlo kire farak na karan tasad active nasla mago kade fakt 2007 che je nivdun zali hat itka sambandh teda bollalo magi tani amcha de sambandh hai thevna ani paksha ne odle che teja sambandh thevna karan paksha che premin thoda baspa kami padlalo.
Our reporters Samir Bhatt and Devidas Kamali with video journalist Dhananjay Swarnakar for Prudent Media.
A leaflet is being circulated in Ramnathi and Bandoda area. The leaflet is carrying photograph and name of Madkai MLA Sudhin Davlikar. Sudhin is supposedly appealing people to stay away from mochas, agitations and public meetings against Sanatan through this leaflet. However, it is not confirmed who is behind this leaflet. Sudhin or his political opponents. Recently, Janajagruti Manch Bandoda was formed under the presidentship of Vasant Bhatt. The Manch had organized a rally on Saturday evening to oppose Sanatan Ashram in their area. Few days back, Vasant Bhatt had alleged that Sudhin has threatened him.
Maja bhauji cha mobile chair ek dhamki aili ki maka ताजे मनीस मारपाक रावल्यात की आपल्याले ऑर्डरीक रावतात वेळ पडल्यार हांगा म्हाजे नोकरीच्यान तो म्हाका काडपाकूय शकता आनी बांदोडे गांवच्यान म्हणजे बांदोडे गांवांत आमकां बहिश्कृत अशें करून सोडपाचे आपल्या कापस्ताद आसा अशेंय बी ताणे आमकां फोनाचेर धमकी दिल्या. आमचोच आमदार.
The recent leaflet is asking people not to fall prey to such elements. It is also asking them not to attend anti-Sanatan meetings. It appeals that people should wait for police to complete their investigation. But it is not confirmed that Sudhin distributed these leaflets. Political analysts feel that this can be a ploy against Sudhin by his political opponents to malign his image. A reporter in Ponda, Vivek Prabhu. Muslims around the world are celebrating Eid al-Adha, commonly known as Bakri Eid. The feast of Bakri Eid is an occasion to give and to sacrifice. Bakri Eid is marked by the slaughter of animals as a sacrificial offering.
Eid ul-Adha, as it is called in Arabic, translates as the feast of sacrifice. Bakri Eid is celebrated to commemorate the willingness of Abraham to sacrifice his son as an act of obedience to God. The festival annually falls on the 10th day of the month of Dhul Hijjah of the lunar Islamic calendar. Bakri Eid occurs the day after Muslims undertake the pilgrimage to the holy place of Mecca. Soon after the morning prayers, devotees sacrifice goats and other animals. The meat is then donated to the poor in the spirit of sacrifice. In Panjim, Muslims were seen offering namaz at the Jama Masjid. Bureau report, Prudent Media.
Time for yet another short break. Stay tuned.